How do all the new fintech apps instantly connect with your bank? Robinhood, Chime, Coinbase, Mint, just to name a few. The answer, Plaid. Hey, my name is Caleb, I'm a software engineer, and when I first heard of Plaid, I thought someone was referring to their outfit, not the largest fintech mass adoption software everyone seems to be using. So in this video, we're gonna break down what Plaid is and how companies are using it. Why apps need your financial information? The easiest way to understand why Plaid exists is to think about some of the apps that actually use it. And for this video, we're going to highlight Venmo. Now, there are thousands of institutions in the universe, and more are coming online. And while the plurality of Venmo's users might be using popular ones like Bank of America, Chase, Capital One, there are millions of potential users who aren't using those banks. And if I'm Venmo, I want to make sure I can cover everybody. Big bank, little bank, everything in between. But that's really challenging. Each one of those have different requirements. Each bank that Venmo wants to connect to has different APIs, authentication schemes, so much more. It's all slightly different. And the other thing that I'm really describing here is not unique to banks or fintech. Any company that relies on integrating struggles with maintaining the nuances of those integrations. I would be surprised if Venmo didn't have a dedicated team pre-Plaid just to handle integrations. The other thing we have to consider is data is moving around a lot. Financial data is among the most sensitive data we have. If you're inputting your username, your password, your account number in the Venmo system to connect to BOA, Capital One, that places a critically important burden on those to steward that data, making sure it's encrypted, handle re-authentication, making sure cybersecurity is in place. It's a whole can of worms that we can dedicate an entire video to, but let's zoom out. The main idea of Plaid is a way to outsource integrations with banking providers. They give you smooth APIs for connecting to and integrating with banks so your engineering teams don't have to. And I want to talk about two user groups when it comes to Plaid. Developers and end users. For developers, they use Plaid to connect their application to financial institutions, and they work with things like account balances, view balances, transaction history. And if you're a developer working at Venmo, you're just gonna hook your app to Plaid so that users can connect to their Capital One accounts and get money into Venmo. Now, Plaid has great developer documentation, and it really comes down to two key concepts. Links, which is the process of connecting your app to a user's bank account, and APIs, which is the process of doing things with that bank account, like viewing balances. Now, this is where Plaid really shines. Despite the fact that each bank has completely different APIs for moving money around, Plaid provides a layer of abstraction so you don't even have to worry about it. You just have to use them. They'll take care of it. Now, for the end user, Plaid isn't just a set of APIs. They also provide a user interface. So some of you might have seen the screen below. That isn't Venmo. That is Plaid. They want to make it as easy to find the most popular banks or any bank and make it easy to log in. And that way you can deposit money into your Venmo account and start using it immediately. Plaid's product expansion strategy could be crazy in the future because they're looking into investing, payroll, and liabilities. Imagine not only a fintech company where it's like, hey, do you want to get approved for a home loan? Let me log in, figure out how much money you got, your transaction history over the past 6 months, and boom, I can approve you for a loan on the spot. I can approve you for a credit card on the spot. So like, sky's the limit from that regard. And the last thing I wanted to clear up is Plaid is not a payment processor. So while their marketing might not make it super clear, they actually don't process or facilitate payments. They just take the integration piece out of your hands, but they are not the ones moving the money around. That's still happening with companies like Stripe or Wells Fargo. But what did we miss? Have you thought about making a fintech app? Did you check out Plaid? If you like this video, make sure to like, comment, subscribe. Tech out.